right, I like it.
And all the way from the Netherlands, Eddie Skibby in Parkview.
This is stiffer than Buccolo. Buccolo is it's the last big one in Europe on the continent. All the main events like Burley and the Championships have been, so they use them for the sort of the up and coming horses or the second swing horses to qualify. Buccolo is normally not hilly. This is very hilly, which makes it a lot stiffer. I mean, the size of the fence might be about the same, but because they're always on the slope, downhill or uphill, it makes it more difficult.
Right.
And of course, the slippery going will make it more difficult.
And he's down now to fence four, the ditch and brush.
Well, you can see all the footings really starting to chew up there, but it came a positive drive. The guy jumped a little bit ahead. The horse was real clever.
Now coming to the boxes at seven.
You got to ride like he was saying earlier. Well. You got to ride aggressive, and there was a bit of
not
a gamble.
Not over the second.
That was a bit of a gamble there.
Can't be building his confidence.
No, this is not building the confidence. He needs to give a kick there. Whoops. Things are, you know, now he's got to, if you walk the course on these type of complexes, there's other options, and he's got a real quick run through his mind, you know, where's the other option, what can I do to get it, like he said, everything's uphill or downhill, and see, and he really isn't sure where he's going now, and so he's going to call it a day, because he knows he's out of the hunt right now with 60.
And out of the four horses that they brought over, he and his wife, Mandy, unfortunately, none of them made it in.
That's really a shame to come over that distance, and that's not the way the Americans, you know, I mean, we didn't plan on that. We want to be very hospitable because we'd like them to come back and compete again, and there'll be another competition.
And now Karen Lundy O'Connor with Shannon. The horse sits in second place right now in 48.2, and she's clean and she's clean.
Yeah, well, she's going to put the pressure on her new husband, even though she demonstrated the forward seat there. She's going to definitely put pressure on her husband, you know, because she doesn't want to do the laundry.
No.
Now look at this. See that? See, she kept it tight. He kept it
well ridden through there.
Patient. That was a very
comes
good ride.
Right
there.
On the inside.
Sometimes mistakes early in the course sharpen you up. And you notice she isn't jumping ahead here now. You know, that one little mistake was what she needed. It was a wake up call to say, hey, you know, you're back out on the course here. You better hold your shoulders and wait a little bit.
And having toured this horse around Europe now, she's gotten to know this mare pretty well.
Well, yeah. Ooh, now the. She got to know her pretty well, but you know, in the rain there, the mare did drop the leg there. But hey, we've been there. That doesn't mean it goes with the horse. It just means it went with that moment.
Yeah.
You know.
Well, that is getting a little chewed up around there. It looks.
And now this, but see, then she came back and jumped it fine. And notice how she—that's what she learned from being over in England. They're stationed in England, land and go away from your jump. And that's why they're so fast over there. As soon as they land, they're gone. Good tidy turn there.
Lovely.
Yep, really nice. See, quick adjustment, slip the rein, look, keep pressing, and then gone.
She's got a good one going.
Yep, she does, I tell you. She's going to put the pressure on her new husband. Good use of the stick there. Did you see that?
Yeah, that was great. Unfortunately, though, it wasn't going to be Karen's day, as she's going to have to stop at the bank up here.
I overcorrected her, and so when she jumped up on the bank, she jumped up very, very well. She ran out to the right.
Safety over 10.
What are you going
to
do?
A little brokenhearted?
Well, I'm not disappointed with the round. I mean, she had a very, very good round, I thought, and jumped very, very well. Disappointed with the end of the day scores? Yeah, very. Anyway.
My condolences.
No, that's quite all right. It's another day.
But that round still slides her into sixth place with Shannon, and she maintains third place and sixth place. Philip Dutton still maintaining the lead. Edie Tarves with her brilliant round moving her into second place. Bruce Davidson now moves into fourth, and Marcia Kulak moves into fifth place. But the weather getting worse, the action gets a little hotter. Our leaders are yet to